Hello, Council Bluffs Area Chamber of Commerce members. This is Drew Kamp, President and CEO of the Council Bluffs Area Chamber of Commerce, for our January 21st weekly legislative update. This is wrapping up the second week of the legislative session that started on the 10th. We already have had some news on some priority issues, but there's not a lot of movement on some of the other key issues. But I did want to just bring attention to a few of the key issues. So the governor's tax bill that she proposed in her condition of the state on Tuesday, the 11th, that did become available. Those bills, both in the House and the Senate study bill and House Senate study bill, became available in their respective Ways and Means committees this week. That would be the bill that would bring about the 4% flat tax. It wouldn't have anything to do with tax credits. We have heard from the Senate Ways and Means Committee that a bill they put forward not only will include sales tax as well as personal and corporate income tax, but also will impact tax credits. So we're watching that conversation very closely as it happens. But we were happy to see the first copy of a bill come out for the governor's proposal, so we can kind of dig our teeth into that and kind of see what we're looking at and what our thoughts are on it. We'll continue to monitor that going forward, and we look forward to seeing what Senator Dawson and his committee come up with in the Senate and working with him and conversing with him on their proposal, because it'll be very far reaching, like I said, including tax credits and sales tax as well. There was a bill Representative Height put out in the House Ways and Means Committee, House Education Committee. He also serves on the House Ways and Means Committee as well, but it has to do with TIFs, and it's specifically with tax increment financing related to wind projects. There's been a lot of counties and some other entities that have utilized windmills for tax increment financing revenue that they can then reinvest back into their communities for economic and community development projects and things along the lines. What this bill would essentially do, it would pull out that school levy, the 540 school levy, from a TIF in any instance in which it's for a wind TIF. So it's something we're watching very closely, as you can imagine, because that's a large portion of your property tax revenue is that school increment there. So that would be very impactful to pull that levy out. So we're watching that bill closely to see what happens as it gets moved over to the Ways and Means Committee. We haven't seen any workforce development bills proposed yet, but we do know there's one going to be put forward on Med-Mal and trucker reform, trucker tort reform. But also then a separate one that'll get put forward on unemployment and code-based changes, really on the unemployment kind of side of things. So we'll keep watching for that. We have seen two childcare bills already come out in the House in advance, one of which would increase the ratios to allow additional children to be seen within childcare centers. So that's something we're watching very closely as we do a lot of work in the childcare space. I also wanted to just bring attention to the fact our first weekly legislative roundtable with our legislators will be next Friday, the 28th, from 12 to 1:30 p.m. So do plan to participate in that. We really look forward to having our local legislators join us and learn about some of the great things they're working on at the Capitol and conversing with them with our opinions and thoughts on some of those key priority issues from our perspective as well. With that, I will conclude this week's weekly legislative update. I appreciate all that you do to support and participate in the Council Bluffs Area Chamber of Commerce. Have a very nice weekend and stay safe and warm out there. Thanks. Bye.